So we made the beds, which are apparently called bedles. Now we need to make the ball. Copy the bed class to ball.lua and replace bed with ball. Empty the functions. We change the arguments to 400, 300, 15 and 15. So now our ball will start in the center of the window. Now we need to make it move. It should start moving right away, so we can do this in the constructor. Self.xSpeed equals 400. Self.ySpeed equals minus 500. Run the game. And you'll see that our ball moves out of the window. The pedal can also move out of the screen. Let's fix this in the entity class. How do we check if the ball hits the top of the window? We basically check if the top of the rectangle is higher than the top of the window. Type the following. If self.y lower than or equal to 0, then end. And here we need to do two things. First, let's bring it back to the right position. Self.y equals 0. If you run the game, you'll see our pedal doesn't move out of the top of the screen anymore. Because when its y position is lower than 0, it will be set to 0. The ball seems to stick to the top. Let's make it bounce. In the if statement type, self.yspeed equals minus self.yspeed. The reason we type it like this is because if we ever change the speed of the ball, we don't have to manually change it in other places in the code. With this, we can say that yspeed equals minus yspeed. In other words, yspeed equals minus minus 400. And 2 times negative makes positive, so minus minus 400 becomes 400. Let's do the same for hitting the bottom. Before I show you how to do it, I want you to try it yourself. Tip, the Y position of the bottom is 600. Okay, so let me show you what I do. If self.y is higher than or equal to 600, then self.y equals 600, self.y speed equals minus self.y speed. And now when I run the game, you'll see that the pedal still moves out of the window. This is because the Y position is at the top of the pedal. We need to check if the bottom of the pedal is hitting the bottom of the window. To get the bottom of the pedal, we simply add the height of the pedal to the Y position. So if self.y plus self.height higher than or equal to 600. And now we need to reposition it correctly. So we type self.y equals 600 minus self.height. So pedal will be placed at the bottom of the window minus its height. Now we need to make it so that when the ball hits the pedal, it will bounce back. We need to check if the ball and the pedal are colliding. In the ball class, create a function called ballBounce with e as parameter. In this function, we make the ball bounce if the ball is colliding with a pedal. So when exactly do two rectangles collide? I made a thing where two rectangles will change upon collision. So now they collide, and now they don't. And I added these lines to show you what is going on. When there is collision, all lines are lit up. So when one line is dark, it means it's not overlapping in all ways. For example, the left line of the red rectangle is lit up when it's further to the left than blue's right side. The right line of red is lit up when it's further to the right than blue's left side. So when they're both lit up, it means there is collision on a horizontal line. The same goes with the top and bottom lines. When all lines are lit up, it means the following. The left side of red is further to the left than the right side of blue. The right side of red is further to the right than the left side of blue. The top side of red is further to the top than the bottom side of blue. The bottom side of red is further to the bottom than the top side of blue. You're probably still confused, but just draw two rectangles in paint and move them around. Try to figure out why it is that they're colliding, or why they're not. Anyway, let's put this in an if statement. First, we need to make locals. Local left1 equals self.x. Local right1 equals self.x plus self.width. Local top1 equals self.y. Local bottom1 equals self.y plus self.height. Now copy these locals and replace 1 with 2 and self with e. Okay, so first we need to check if the left side of 1 is further to the left than the right side of 2. So we type if left 1 lower than right 2, then Next, we check if the right side of 1 is further to the right than the left side of 2. If right 1 higher than left 2, then... Okay, hold on, we're going to get a bunch of if statements here, but we can actually put it in one if statement. Before the then of the first if statement, we put an and. Behind the and, we put the next statement. So, left 1 lower than right 2, and right 1 higher than left 2. With and, both conditions must be true to pass the if statement. Let's add another and. This time, type top 1 lower than bottom 2. Feel free to put the code on a new line if it becomes too long. Except with strings and commas, Lua doesn't care about new lines. One more statement. Bottom 1 higher than top 2. In the if statement, we print test for now. Let's check if it works. In the update function of the game class, call the function with right pedal as argument. Self.ball bounce self.pad right. Run the game and you will see that test is printed multiple times. That means it works. Each test is for every update the ball hits the pedal. Now let's make it bounce. Inside the if statement, we type self.xSpeed equals minus self.xSpeed. Now when we run the game, you'll see that our ball will bounce off the pedal. Add self.ball bounce self.pad left in the game class. Now it bounces back and forth between both pedals. That's it for this video. In the next video, we'll be keeping scores and finishing the game. Thanks for watching.